Welcome to the All-State Game of the Week on ESPNU.
It is the All-State Game of the Week as North Carolina State takes on Virginia in Charlottesville. Virginia with a huge win over Georgia Tech last week. You are watching the ACC on ESPN. And it was 1 week ago on this very field at Scott Stadium that Virginia pulled off a huge upset over unbeaten and 12th-ranked Georgia Tech. Mike London's team holding Georgia Tech to season lows in just about every offensive category. It was homecoming here. The fans stormed the field, and Virginia came away with a big 24-21 win. And we welcome you back to Scott Stadium. Pam Ward along with former Boise State and Colorado head coach Dan Hawkins. And Hawk, you and just about every other head coach has faced this before. You've beaten a team, big win 1 week. How do you guard against a letdown the next week?
Well, you want to take the juice from the win. You want that confidence and all that good feeling of what you can become. But you have to be careful that you don't just take it for granted. So it's a fine line that Coach London needs to walk today.
And Mike London is in his second year as the head coach here at the University of Virginia. And since 2005, back when Al Groh was still the head coach, Virginia just 2-4 the next week after they beat a ranked team. Last year, they beat Miami. The next week, Miami was ranked at the time, they lost to Duke and didn't win another game all season. So they'll try and guard against that. His counterpart on the other sideline is Tom O'Brien. In his fifth season at NC State, his defense decimated by injuries. And now the bad news for his team, they will be without TJ Graham for the first half of this game. What is being called not living up to NC State expectations, they will miss him.
Huge blow for the Wolfpack. Mike Glennon needs to go to him in the passing game, and he's great in the special teams category as well. It's a motivational hit because one of your leaders, and a tactical hit because you need him physically.
And they also will be without another wide receiver, Tobias Palmer, who is Graham's backup. Suffered a concussion in the warm-ups today, so he is out. So the season of injuries continues for NC State. NC State won the toss and deferred. Virginia will get the football first. Darius Jenkins, a true freshman, takes it up the near sideline, close to the 30-yard line. That's a nice 24-yard return for him. So Virginia comes out first with the football. Virginia 4-2 on the season, 1-1 in the ACC. There's a flag down on the kickoff.
It was offside by the kicking team, number 30. 5-yard penalty, re-kick.
Brad Allen, our referee this afternoon, and Mike London has decided to go ahead and let NC State re-kick.
That's a telling sign, I think. When you want the team to re-kick, they've got great field position as it is, but when you want them to re-kick, you're basically saying our kickoff return team has a potential to take it to the house, and we think we can gouge you. So I think this is a great moxie move for the Cavaliers here.
Could have had the ball at the 34. Let's see what happens as the kickoff is now moved back to the 25-yard line. On the other side of the field, Darius Jennings, there you see him, a true freshman from Baltimore, averaging about 21 yards per kick return and had a 24-yarder the last time, but his head coach, Mike London, has decided he wants to give it another go. And kicking off, Nicholas Sadie, German-born place kicker for NC State. Here is our second opening kickoff of the game. This one for real. And that is Kalik Shepherd, who retreats all the way back to his two. He has a nice lane. Virginia will indeed gain yards by making NC State re-kick a 48-yard return for Shepherd.
Love it, Pam. That's getting your team on the attack. We're not going to take the passive route. You kick this thing again because we're going to get after you. That's a statement by Virginia right there.
And by doing that, they picked up 16 yards on the re-kick. Michael Rocco, sophomore out of Lynchburg, Virginia, first-year starter, will split some snaps with true freshman David Watford at quarterback. Perry Jones, he was the man last week, running for a career-high 149 yards against Georgia Tech, and he gets a first down.
Perry Jones, you saw him there. They outrushed Georgia Tech last week. He's a key to getting the running game going, and he's a key in the throwing game, catching screens and short passes out of the backfield. Audie Cole is their main pass rusher, and with the injuries they've had up front, he needs to do a great job at that inside linebacker spot.
They are missing three defensive linemen who have started games for them. Perry Jones on first down, not getting much. Marcus Kuhn, a German native, like the place kicker we saw in the opening kickoff. Kuhn, also born in Germany. Started playing football at 15. That's the youngest you can play football over in Germany. And he's on scholarship, actually has already graduated from NC State. Brings up a second and nine. NC State, by the way, coming off a bye week. A couple of weeks ago, they had a win against Central Michigan, but they have lost to Wake Forest and Georgia Tech in ACC games. Second and nine. And a short, or low pass, I should say, to Max Million, their fullback, who actually loses about a yard on that. Let's look at Dan Hawkins' keys to the game.
The formula for Virginia has been, will be, and continue to be a balanced attack. They've got to be able to run the football, stay balanced to set up their play action game. North Carolina State needs to bring pressure because they don't have big enough or enough bodies up front to stop the run game. So expect extra pressure from the defense of the Wolfpack.
A true freshman, T.Y. McGill, one of the starting defensive tackles for NC State. They wanted to redshirt him, but because of injuries, they had to burn his shirt, and he's a starter. Third and long, and that pass is one-hopped. Tim Smith, the intended receiver, so Virginia started with very good field position, but were unable to get anything going on offense, and the punter, Jimmy Howell, comes out.
Good pressure there by North Carolina State. They got a hand on that ball and ended up tipping it.
Jimmy Howell only had to punt twice last week in that 24-21 win over Georgia Tech. Rashard Smith awaits the rugby punt. Virginia chases it down. Terrific coverage downfield for the Cavaliers. Ray Keyes, a backup wide receiver, number 86, getting there to kill the ball around the 2-yard line.
Great special teams play. Excellent job. You can tell they've worked on this, getting to the goal line, then finding the ball. That's the game of the Virginia Cavaliers, field possession and controlling the line of scrimmage, making the other team. Georgia Tech had a number of long drives last week, and it was not good for them.
Terrific job by Howell, great coverage by Keyes, and here's our first look today at Mike Glennon, quarterback late joining the huddle. 16 touchdowns, that is first in the ACC, sixth in the nation. Trying to get a little breathing room, they give it to James Washington, their tailback, who is coming off of back-to-back 100-yard games on the ground.
Wolfpack need to get a little out of their running game today, Pam. Otherwise, it's going to be tough for Mike Glennon just to win it on his own, especially with T.J. Graham over on the sideline.
NC State averaging just over 116 yards per game. That is ninth in the ACC, 95th in the nation. They come out in a three-receiver set, but handoff again. And able to get out to the 10-yard line, James Washington, tackled by Nick Jenkins. As we look at James Washington, who just had the football as an impact player.
Well, Mustafa Green was their starter earlier in the year, and James Washington needs to be big today. They've got to control the line of scrimmage with the rushing game. Chase Minifield was the James Thorpe Award winner after a big interception and big game against Georgia Tech last week. He'll be counted on to shut down Mike Glennon.
He did that to Stephen Hill last week. They only threw to Hill twice. He made one catch. And then on third and one, the easy first down, James Washington picked up eight. First down, NC State. Corey Mosley had to make the stop for the Cavaliers. Mike Glennon stepping in, a junior from Centerville, Virginia, and he is the younger brother of Sean Glennon, who had a very good career at Virginia Tech. Glennon at 6'6". The second tallest quarterback in the FBS. And they're keeping it on the ground. Washington picked up a couple. Sean Glennon playing at Virginia Tech. up until about 3 years ago, and Sean now working in the Washington, D.C. area, and his brother Mike deciding to go to NC State. In fact, Mike played a high school championship game on this field when he played for Westfield High School, won the 2007 state championship on this field. Second down, his throw, first throw of the game, is good for completion, picking up about 5 yards. His target is Jay Smith. This is a very depleted wide receiver core now, with Graham sitting out the first half and Tobias Palmer out for the game.
Nice statement by North Carolina State. You see the quick out throw over here. Mike Glennon has an NFL arm. He needs to have receivers that can keep up with that arm today, at least as long as till T.J. Graham can come off the bench.
Third and three for NC State. They have already converted on one third down on this drive. Virginia bringing pressure. Glennon hit as he threw. Jake Snyder with the hit, and then Leroy Reynolds came in to knock the pass down.
Bringing zone blitz off the right side. Both the inside linebacker and outside linebacker can't get there initially, but great job getting up and blocking the ball. And when you're 6'6 and that ball coming out, I think you've got to be a volleyball blocker. Excellent, excellent technique by the Cavaliers.
Cavaliers with 17 sacks on the season, which is best in the ACC. No sack there, obviously, but great pressure on Glennon to force the punt by Will Baumann. Contact around the punter, no flag. Fair catch after a 36-yard punt by Baumann. Mike London's team, scoreless early against NC State, have the ball when we come back. Welcome back. You are watching the ACC on ESPN. Virginia and NC State scoreless in the first quarter. Mike London is in charge, the head coach of the UVA offense. We're about to see him again.
This is the formula that they've been using. Power running game to make the defense commit to the line of scrimmage. Then they come back with some great play action, taking a shot with Mike Rocco here, going downfield. They'll also get David Watford in. Nice play action again. The defense has to play the running game and open up the pass. Then they have a nice screen game, particularly on third downs, and throwing the ball out to Perry Jones, who's a dual threat running and catching.
Perry Jones, in fact, is the second leading receiver on this team and the leading rusher. Kevin Parks, usually a more of a short yardage back, is in there, and he stumbled as they got the handoff from Rocco. They actually might have run into each other. No gain. There is Kevin Parks. He has 7 rushing touchdowns, which has tied the Virginia freshman mark, as opposed to Perry Jones, the starter, who's a junior who only has 3 rushing touchdowns in his entire career. Second and 10 for the Cavaliers. Now Rocco goes against the grain, completes it to Parks out of the backfield. Good defense by NC State. Rashard Smith, the corner, holding it to only a 1-yard gain.
Third and long, not the formula that the Cavaliers are looking for. They'd like to be in a little bit more manageable situation, not being a must-throw down.
Michael Rocco going to the wristbands on third and fourth down. He's completing 71% of his passes, much better than his 63% on the season. Perry Jones back in at tailback. Max Million, the fullback, in there as well. Jones goes in motion, lines up in the slot. Rocco with the short pass to Darius Jennings, and Jennings gets hardly anything at all. Brandon Bishop made the stop for NC State. So here's Virginia. 2 drives, 1 started at midfield, the other started at his 40, and here comes their second punt.
When you don't have a success, we saw success in the first down in the previous series. This time we did not have success, no gain on the first down, sets up a series of plays of too much down and distance for Virginia.
They have thrown 3 screens and gotten a total of only 3 yards out of them so far. Jimmy Howell, last time he kicked a 37-yarder that was killed at the 1-yard line. Rashard Smith retreats, called for it, Fair catch at the 11. That's where NC State takes over after the 46-yard punt by Howell. ESPNU College Football All-State Game of the Week, brought to you by Allstate. Shop less, get more. Make one call to an Allstate agent. Back here in Charlottesville, the campus of the University of Virginia. That's the rotunda. They call it the grounds here, but it's a campus to us mere mortals. Tom O'Brien spent a lot of time here on campus, 15 years, in fact, as an assistant at the University of Virginia from 1982 to 1996 when George Welsh was the head coach here. So some great memories for Tom O'Brien. We talked to him about it earlier this week as Mike London, who was the head coach on the other sideline, was his defensive line coach at Boston College. Coach O'Brien, the most wins in the history of BC, and is now remarkably in his fifth year already here at NC State. First down, Glennon going deep, has a man, and he hit him in full stride, but Brian Underwood could not catch it. A perfectly thrown football, Hawkins, and he couldn't bring it in.
Yeah, I've admired Tom O'Brien taking a shot, coming off play action, which it heavily in the down. Mike Glennon, great play action, puts it where only his guy can catch it. Unfortunately, just a little bit of a drop. Corey Mosley getting there just at the end to be able to get a little bit of pressure. Keep Brian Underwood from making that catch.
Underwood has only 5 catches on the season, but is averaging 15 yards per catch, and he let one get away that time. Second down, right back to the run to James Washington, who has had some success out to the 20, where he is tackled by Steve Greer. Greer, the leading tackler on this team. Washington now 27 yards on 5 carries.
Looks like the Cavaliers, and rightfully so, trying to defend Mike Glennon in the throw game. But North Carolina State early on doing a nice job running the football and controlling the line of scrimmage. We'll see if Virginia counters with a little more pressure of their own.
Third and one for State. Washington gets the first down, this time over the right side of that offensive line. Picked up 3. There is TJ Graham on the sideline. In case you're just joining us, he will not play in the first half for a violation of team standards. But he will be available. He's got his helmet on like he's going to go in any time now, but we won't see him till the third quarter.
Well, Pam, I think one of the great things about football is teaching young men about life, and these guys need to understand the microscope that they're under and the standards they need to live up to.
Tom O'Brien, a former Marine, went to the Naval Academy, kind of a no-nonsense guy, good disciplinarian. Matt Conrad stopping Washington that time after a 2-yard gain. And there is Graham. He has been really electric this year. At one point had 3 straight 100-yard receiving games and is second in the nation in all-purpose yards. They miss him.
He's electric in the special teams category. And like I said, kids will make mistakes at times, but it's great when coaches hold guys accountable. That's how they learn and get better.
70% of the time, NC State has kept it on the ground. Tony Creasy in for James Washington at the tailback spot now on 2nd and 8. Glennon under big time pressure. Good call on the screen. That was Creasy, who just came into the game. His 3rd catch of the season, good for 6 yards. Creasy, a redshirt freshman from Durham.
I like the screen there early, Pam, on 2nd down. I just think sometimes 3rd and long, everybody in the stadium's yelling screen. I like to see it a little early in the package.
And that brings up another 3rd down. And another 3rd and short. They are 2 for 3 on 3rd down so far this afternoon. Creasy's still in there at tailback, and he gets it. That's a huge hole right up the middle. And Rodney McLeod came up with what might have been a touchdown-saving tackle.
Coming back with a little trap to the right side. Splits it right in the A-gap. Nobody left but the free safety. Not a good sign when you're on defense.
Creasy picked up 16 yards on that carry. Rodney McLeod had a brilliant game last week with 7 tackles against Georgia Tech and was able to get Creasy down after 16 yards. NC State already with 48 rush yards. Play action. And Glennon on the money to Jay Smith for another NC State first down. 15 more yards.
Been set up by great running game, and Virginia being very aware of that early. They're trying to fake a little draw, and they got almost a bubble screen outside. Mike Glennon throws it in behind as they're anticipating jumping that bubble screen up on the line of scrimmage.
Dana Bible is the offensive coordinator under Tom O'Brien. Those two were together at Boston College, and Bible and company really lost a lot of playmakers from last year, including Russell Wilson, their quarterback, who's now at Wisconsin. Glennon is the man now, looking into the end zone. Chase Minifield down there. He is their best cover corner. The intended receiver was Stephen Howard. Tom O'Brien in his fifth year at NC State, 15th year overall as a head coach, and really did terrific things at Boston College before coming south, where he is 28-28. Had a great season last year. They expected good things this year, but boy, the injuries. And you talk to Tom O'Brien, Dana Bible, who's been in coaching for over 35 years, same with their defensive coordinator, have never seen a rash of injuries like they have seen this year. Glennon rolling, nowhere to go. Throws it towards the end zone, and it is dropped again. Quentin Payton that time with an opportunity as Glennon took a chance.
Mike Glennon showing his ability to run as well. He's pressured by Steve Greer, but he's 6'6" and has a chance to get outside the pocket. Makes a great throw. Need to be able to come up with that ball right there.
Wow, Dom Joseph was down there defending. That was a touchdown dropped by Underwood right in his belly. So two drop passes by NC State in this game. That one should have been a touchdown. 3rd and 10, Virginia brings pressure and a flag down on Rodney McLeod, who was covering Payton, who just dropped the touchdown throw.
Virginia bringing 6 there. Caused Glennon to get that ball off on a hot throw.
Prior to the pass being thrown, there was holding on the defense, number 4, against an eligible receiver. 10 yards from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
Quentin Payton went a little bit of a double move, got the hot throw. Rodney McLeod got hung up on that first stick move and had to grab him. Probably if he hadn't, it had been a touchdown anyway, so you don't like the penalty, but probably better than the touchdown right here.
Puts the ball down at the 27-yard line. NC State has thrown the ball 4 times downfield on this drive alone. A couple of drop passes downfield, and there the holding call. Washington back in there to run the ball and only picks up a couple. Check that, it was Tony Creasy in there for Washington at the tailback spot. Steve Greer in the middle, the leading tackler on this team, had a terrific game last week against Georgia Tech. What a great game plan that Jim Reed drew up, the defensive coordinator for Virginia. And we talked to him yesterday. There's a good look at Reed, a very enthusiastic guy, but he was concerned about a letdown and coming into this game. And also, they practiced against a triple option. Now they're back to playing regular defense. Another pass that's dropped. Jay Smith this time. Boy, Mike Glennon is putting balls right where they should be caught.
And he will do most of the day. You wonder how many guys on the sideline are staring at TJ Graham right now, wishing he was in the football game. I like the mix of run and play action that North Carolina State has given Virginia. And as you mentioned, Pam, talking about Jim Reed, they go from 1 week to triple option where it's almost all run to a team that's a pro-style throwing attack. That's a tough adjustment.
Jim Reed said a lot of the detail was missing from practice early in the week. Washington runs into a pile right at the line and maybe picked up a yard. So drop passes really hurting NC State. Three drops on this drive. And now it's fourth down. Tom O'Brien deciding to send out the kicker, Nicholas Sadie. 4 for 6 on the year. A true freshman, as is the snapper and the holder, the only teams to have true freshmen in all three spots. Chase Minifield came in and blocked it. A 41-yard attempt blocked by Minifield. NC State hurt by drops earlier in this drive and then hurt by Chase Minifield blocking the field goal. We are still scoreless in Charlottesville. Charlottesville, University of Virginia is scoreless against NC State. Chase Minifield, number 13 in the picture, senior, has blocked a field goal to keep this game scoreless. But boy, NC State not helping out with three drop passes, including a drop touchdown on that last drive. Pass completed to Tim Smith. David Emerson, who has a slew of interceptions, was on the coverage. And boy, a lot of drops. Glennon just not getting helped out by his receivers.
T.J. Graham getting a lot of mean stares on the sideline. They'd love to have him out there. That combined with Tobias Palmer out with a concussion. Time for Jay Smith. These guys need to step up and make a play for their great quarterback.
And that drive ended with Chase Minifield blocking the field goal. Quentin Payton actually dropped a touchdown pass on that drive that he did not show you. There's good running by Perry Jones for the first down for the Cavaliers. Jones, a junior from Chesapeake, Virginia. His coach, Bill Lazor, the offensive coordinator, calls him Superman because he is so invaluable and does a lot of things. He's very versatile.
They've got a whole stable of running backs at Virginia. They've got four deep between Jones, Parks, Shepard, and Richardson.
First and 10. And then coming around from the end position is Darius Jennings. He's a kid who was a high school quarterback and now playing wide receiver. Picked up a yard. Terrell Manning made the stop for NC State. But they are really just, the offensive coordinator Bill Lazor says that both Jennings and Dominique Terrell, who was another true freshman, are becoming receivers. There's Bill Lazor, who is down on the sidelines, learning how to become receivers after really, as high school quarterbacks, doing a lot of running. Second and 9, Parks is the tailback. He gets it. Slips through a hole and carries a couple of guys forward to the 46-yard line. Picked up about 4 tough yards on that play. ESPN News coverage of college football continues tonight. Trent Steelman and Army take on Zach Stacy and Vanderbilt. College football primetime presented by 5-Hour Energy. That follows us tonight on ESPNU at 7 Eastern time. Get to see Army run the football a little bit in that game.
We're seeing some of that here. Last play, Virginia used a similar scheme they used against Georgia Tech. Switching the tight end in the line of scrimmage and motion the split end across to get an unbalanced advantage.
Third and 5, flag is down. Rocco, everybody's covered, another flag down. Rocco slides for what would be a first down, but I think we're gonna get a Virginia hold. That was an 8-yard gain.
Holding, offense number 72, 10-yard penalty, third down.
Ode Abushi, the left tackle, called for the foul. There's a good look at Ode, 6'6", 310-pounder.
Coming to the top of the screen. North Carolina State getting an edge and getting some pressure, just too long in the pocket.
So Abushi with the hold. However, the defense was offside. So they offset, and we're just going to replay the down as the first quarter is close to coming to a close. Mike London on the sidelines. Second year as a head coach. Was a head coach for 2 years at Richmond, his alma mater. Won it all. The FCS, also known as 1AA Championship in 2008. So here's third and five yet again. Baracco throws, first down. Chris Bird with a nice move after he caught the ball to get a few extra yards.
Coach Bill Lazor, offensive coordinator for Virginia, talked about trying to come up with some easy completions. Little whip route outside, gives a little separation, pretty easy throw for the quarterback. A lot of zone coverage by North Carolina State, particularly three deep. You can anticipate being that four or three deep underneath and having some holes to throw to. Mike Rocco just needs to be able to find him.
Yep, they want to get him into a good rhythm, be efficient with the running game, and find completions. They found that one to Bird, as Virginia was not able to get
prior
the playoff.
The quarter has expired.
Before the quarter expired. Explanation from Brad Allen, our referee. Scoreless after one quarter of play. Virginia trying to bounce back after a very emotional win against Georgia Tech. NC State hurt by some dropped passes, so we're scoreless heading to the second. We're in Scott Stadium at the University of Virginia. After one quarter of play, Virginia and NC State are scoreless. Pam Ward and Dan Hawkins joining you on a beautiful afternoon in Charlottesville. Nice sunny skies, and not a nice sunny sky for NC State. Three drop passes already, including a touchdown, a would-be touchdown that was dropped. Virginia winning the field position battle, starting on its 39 on average. NC State just on its six. First play of the second quarter, Perry Jones lost the football over there. NC State says they have it. They have the most takeaways in the ACC this year. Dwayne Maddox forced the fumble. Just a matter of who fell on it.
Not the formula for success for any team, but particular Virginia, Pam. Need to stay positive down and distance, avoid the negative plays.
Perry Jones was able to recover his own fumble. The ball
Dwayne Maddox doing a nice job getting his hand in there. Modern day defense is not just tackling. You better keep that ball high and tight or somebody's going to pull that thing away from your body.
NC State had a lot of chances to come up with that football, and somehow Jones was able to get on it. Kevin Parks now in there. Rocco back to pass, looking for Parks, and has him over on the far sideline. Parks battling. Great effort by the redshirt freshman from Salisbury, North Carolina. Picks up seven. Terrell Manning had a chance to wrap him up a little bit earlier, but Parks just kept going.
One of those easy completions. Offensive coordinator Bill Lazor talked about flat route. Mike Rocco doing a nice job not forcing it downfield, just checking it down to his back, and then you break a tackle and you get a good play out of it.
Mike Archer, NC State's defensive coordinator, concerned about some of those things that Virginia would be doing today. And they executed that play, third and one. Parks, their short yardage guy, easily gets the first down for Virginia as we get our first visit with Ari Noka. Have to wonder, thank you, Dari, how Georgia Tech is going to respond from their loss on this field last week. Taking a look at Georgia Tech with some explosive plays, but they were held in check by Jim Reed and his Virginia defense here last week. Rocco on the roll, throwing it mostly out of bounds. Good coverage that time by the NC State defenders. Daryl Cato Bishop got a lot of pressure on Rocco.
Good offensive counter, again, shifting the tight end, motioning to unbalance, and coming back with a play action to the weak side. Give North Carolina State credit for staying at home back there and getting it covered up.
Now Clifton Richardson, the third of the tailbacks we have seen for Virginia, who are about to run their 10th play of this drive. Richardson gets the pitch, cuts it back inside all the way down to the 20-yard line. Brandon Bishop made the stop after a 4-yard gain. Richardson lost a shoot.
Virginia starting to have some success running the football outside. They were able to use a block and pull scheme last week against Georgia Tech. North Carolina State's done a nice job stopping their off-tackle power game, so they're trying to get outside to get a little more yards.
Bill Lazor mixing it up a little bit with this offense, but still scoreless. This drive is 5.5 minutes old. Rocco retreats, tucks and runs, and then stretches for the first down. The sophomore from Lynchburg, 6'3", 225, gets the first down with his feet. Not known as the most mobile of quarterbacks, but he looked pretty nifty there.
The thing he's doing a nice job of is he's down in the red area. Don't put your team at a disadvantage. Duck the ball and run and get what you can get. Awesome extra effort, but also more importantly, just managing the situation.
6-for-8 so far. Richardson back there at tailback, gets the carry. Drags a couple of guys down inside the 10, picks up 4. NC State has a defense struggling in the red zone. They are last in the ACC in that category. And Virginia had been perfect in the red zone until a couple of games ago against Idaho. And so they have seen their numbers slip in the red zone, but still more proficient at it, at scoring, than NC State has been at keeping their opponents from scoring. 2nd and 6. Richardson again. Boy, a great second effort by the Virginia tailback. Picks up another 4.
Usually in the red area, to be successful offensively, you must run the football. And typically defenses that struggle, they're not stopping the run. And you're seeing the big offensive line of Virginia leaning on North Carolina State.
As we talked about, last two games, just 5-for-9 after they had been perfect in their first 4. They had to beat Idaho, had to go to overtime to beat Idaho, and then was able to beat Georgia Tech here last week. They are 3-for-3 on third downs on this drive alone. Rocco looking to pass. In trouble, everybody's covered. Throws it into the end zone, and he finds Clinton Richardson for the touchdown. Rocco extended the play, waited for Richardson to just get a little bit of daylight, and he put the ball in there.
Typically, you're going to tell your quarterback never, 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 ever throw the ball late down the middle, particularly down here. He gets one, and he gets away with it. I'm guessing Coach Lazor is going to say, hey, congratulations, nice play, but when he gets to the sideline.
Yeah. High risk, high reward that time as Robert Randolph kicks the extra point, and Virginia has scored our first points of the game. That is only the 6th passing touchdown on the season for Virginia. They go up 7-0. Clifton Richardson celebrating his first collegiate catch, and it was for a touchdown.
Trying to run a couple double crossers right here. Mike Rocco doesn't have the throw out in the flat. Tries to extend the play, which he does well. Clifton Richardson not really in the progression. And this is where Mike did a nice job managing the game last week for a period of time, and then he threw an ill-timed interception for a touchdown. He just needs to make sure he keeps that momentum going this week.
Look at that, 7.5 minutes they chewed up. They converted 4 third downs, including the touchdown on that drive. David Amerson gets the kick return, their star cornerback. He shows he could be a pretty good returner as well. That's a 25 return out to the 30 as we get you back to Dari Noka.
All right, Pam, time for a Sports Center right now, presented by Discover Card. Clemson trying to remain unbeaten, and they do, by downing North Carolina 59-38. Five touchdown passes by Taj Boyd. That ties the school record. Oklahoma State also stays undefeated. They beat Missouri on the road by three touchdowns. Justin Blackman did leave with concussion-like symptoms, but head coach Mike Gundy says he should be okay. Guys?
Thank you very much, Dari. We are back here. Virginia leading NC State 7-0. Four receivers set for State on their third possession of the game, and they complete it to Quinton Payton. Check that. That's Tony Creasy out of the backfield for a 14-yard gain.
Virginia playing cover two there. Back slips out. Got one-on-one with the inside linebacker. That's probably a match that you like from an offensive standpoint.
Yeah, that was Steve Greer, the middle backer that he was lined up with. Greer, a 6'2", 225-pound junior out of Solon, Ohio. Probably go with Creasy every time in that matchup. First down, running play. Creasy picks up about 4 yards. Will Hill making the stop for Virginia.
Saw North Carolina State take 5 shots down the field in the first quarter. Gotta wonder when they're gonna load that back up.
Tom O'Brien's team needs to win 4 of its last 6 games in order to be bowl eligible. That's because they have 2 wins against FCS schools, so a tough road for them if they want to go back to a bowl for the second straight year. Another check down to Creasy, and he picks up another NC State first down. Asar Walcott made the stop, but it's 12 more yards for the Wolfpack. And they are outgaining Virginia right now, but they're down 7-0. So Mike Glennon is the quarterback, redshirt junior, who only played in 10 games in his first 2 years, backing up Russell Wilson, but a guy who came in with good credentials and really high praise indeed from his coaching staff. James Washington's turn to get the ball, and he is taken down after a 6-yard gain. So Russell Wilson was a terrific player, baseball player as well for NC State. He threw for over 8,500 yards and ran for over 1,000. But the comparisons in numbers, Coach, are fairly similar.
Mike Glennon is a bona fide NFL prospect, and I know some people got on Coach O'Brien because obviously Russell's playing well, but Mike Glennon is a bona fide player.
Wilson doing great things, a Heisman candidate at Wisconsin. They have a huge game tonight against Michigan State. Our game day guys are there. James Washington dropped for no gain. Russell Wilson could have come back and played one more year, but Coach O'Brien feeling it was time to move on. Wilson missed a couple of spring practices because he is a baseball player, and they knew they had Glennon in the bullpen. And there was a chance that he might have looked elsewhere to finish his collegiate career. And this coaching staff, who were at Boston College together, look at Glennon, and they see a lot of Matt Ryan in this kid, and that's really high praise. A taller version of Matt Ryan with a better arm than Matt Ryan. And that's coming from them, not from us. That's their comparison. Now he pulls it down. Glennon, the Virginia native, running for a first down. Picks up 12 yards. Came out of high school, he was ranked as the number 3 quarterback by ESPN.
What's happening is Virginia, respecting Mike Glennon, is playing a lot of 2 deep, so you've got to take 2 safeties and commit them, and that leads to a lesser number of guys in the box to defend the run. And then obviously Mike Glennon, he can run for a big guy now. That's an advantage for North Carolina State.
First down for State at the 23-yard line. Glennon has time. Throws underneath to Brian Underwood, and Underwood turns on the Jets. Down to the 10-yard line. Picks up another first down for the Pack. Chase Minifield had to chase him down. Mike Glennon trying to respond from a 7.5-minute touchdown drive for Virginia. They've covered 60 yards in only 3.5 minutes on this drive. First and goal, just inside the 10. Creasy. Got some tough yardage there. Leroy Reynolds made the stop, picked up about 4.
Defensive coordinator Jim Reed for Virginia continuing to respect the throwing game of North Carolina State, and North Carolina State continuing to answer with the running game.
There's Coach Reed, defensive coordinator at Boston College in 2004, former head coach at Richmond. Really did a brilliant job last week in shutting down that Georgia Tech offense, but a whole different dog this afternoon with the Wolfpack. Second and goal, keeping it on the ground, nothing doing that time. Creasy taken down by Rodney McLeod, picked up maybe a yard on that play, and it brings up a third and goal.
Had a chance to watch practice yesterday, Pam. I really loved just the positive energy by this staff and Jim Reed running around. He actually subbed himself in at linebacker on one play, was coaching up the linebackers and kind of made a stick on one of the kids. He can bring it.
And he's not the biggest guy in the world either, Coach Reed.
But feisty.
Got a lot of heart. Yes, he is feisty. Third and goal for State. Glennon. The blitz was on, so he throws it right down the middle to Tony Creasy. Touchdown, NC State. Glennon's 17th touchdown pass of the season. Good call against the blitz and a good drive by NC State.
Cam Johnson gets some pressure with a twist inside. That's a benefit of a veteran quarterback, because you live by the blitz, you die by the blitz.
70-yard drive capped off by Creasy's touchdown catch. Sadie's kick ties the game up at 7. Mike Glennon. More touchdown passes than anybody in the Atlantic Coast Conference this season. There's TD pass number 17 to tie up this game. Welcome back to Charlottesville. Tony Creasy catching a 5-yard pass from Mike Glennon. Glennon on that touchdown drive for NC State, 4 for 4, including the touchdown, and had a big first down run on a third down. Nifty. 10-play, 70-yard drive to tie this game up at 7 apiece. They countered a big Virginia drive. 72 yards. It took 7.5 minutes that culminated with their touchdown. That was Michael Rocco's touchdown pass to Clifton Richardson. Sadie's kick. Darius Jennings, the true freshman returner. Flying for some extra yardage out to the 32-yard line. That's a 22-yard return. Rashard Smith made the tackle. Last time Virginia had the ball, there was a key fumble. Perry Jones was able to recover his own fumble, kept the drive alive, and then this pass that maybe shouldn't have, ought to have been thrown, but it still was a touchdown. Rocco taking a chance at finding Clifton Richardson. Richardson's first career catch is for a touchdown. And the new quarterback is in, David Watford, coming in for Virginia. They have been alternating their quarterbacks. Watford typically coming in the fourth series of the game. But we had an offensive lineman move. This is indeed the fourth drive, so this is going by the book for UVA to put Watford in.
False start. 89, offense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Subtle difference between the cadence of one guy to another, and it's amazing how much that'll throw you off. One guy pauses just a millisecond in between the snap count. O-line can't anticipate it.
Watford, a true freshman from Hampton, Virginia. Very mobile. They've worked on his throwing motion, thought he had too much of a windup trying to get his mechanics sound. He hands it off to Perry Jones, and Jones explodes over the left side of the line. Picks up about 7 yards. Bishop and Anderson come up with the tackle. Watford, a very promising quarterback, and before last week's Georgia Tech game, Mike London, the head coach, said he was breathing, Watford was breathing down Rocco's neck. But Coach London likes to do that, create some competition really in just about every position. Watford just 1-for-5 last week against Georgia Tech, and that one's picked off. And it's Amerson, of course it is. Amerson leading the country in interceptions, comes up with another one. His 7th of the season.
North Carolina State playing cover two. Amerson squats and the route is readjusted up the sideline. Miscommunication between the receiver and David Watford. That's where that inexperience is going to kill you. Needs to see that fade going up the sideline there.
Darius Jennings, the intended receiver, and Amerson, a guy who will take some chances. Jumps some routes, leading the nation now with 7 interceptions this season. That's the first turnover of the game. And he is now 1 interception off the NC State single season record for picks. They will review upstairs to make sure that Amerson did indeed catch the ball.
Here's the thing that makes those coordinators nervous, because you've got a true freshman playing receiver and a true freshman playing quarterback. They adjust the coverage. You've got guys on different pages here.
So as they take a look at this upstairs, we will take a quick timeout. We'll let us know if Amerson's interception holds up. David Amerson has been credited with his 7th interception of the season. They looked at it upstairs. Not enough evidence to overturn it. What do you think, Coach Hawkins?
Doesn't matter what I think.
Oh, everything. The whole world matters on what you think. There has to be enough evidence to overturn it. They ruled upstairs. It was not confirmed, but certainly they did not overturn it. And you need indisputable video evidence to do that. So that the interception stands, and the team that has picked off more passes than any team in the ACC, and Amerson has 7 of the 12, leading the country in that category. Sets up NC State. They're in good shape. First down. Glennon, play action, takes the shot down the field, has a man for a touchdown. Perfectly thrown pass to Brian Underwood.
Going back to the deep ball formula. Pressure by Virginia, picked up. Nicely executed.
Boy, Underwood had one of those drops earlier in this game. Did not drop that one. That was a perfectly executed play. Great throw by Glennon, who has 2 touchdown passes today. Sadie in for the extra point. ...33-yard touchdown. After the interception by Amerson, State strikes. Glennon. Now with 18 touchdown passes on the season, Underwood takes it in. NC State leads for the first time. Welcome back, Brian Underwood. Right there, scoring his first collegiate touchdown. The redshirt freshman, his 33-yard strike for Mike Glennon.
Matched up, free safety gets locked up. Play action against Demetrius Nicholson, another freshman on this Virginia team. We've had 3 true freshmen here in the last few downs. That's the growing pains of a young team.
NC State needed just 1 play after the Amerson interception to take its first lead of the game. Darius Jennings, with the kickoff, finding some running room up the far sideline. 28-yard return as we return to Dari Noka.
All right, Pam, thank you much. Let's update. How about a Dr. Pepper conference update out of the ACC? E.J. Manuel to Kenny Shaw, 26 yards. Florida State up 14-0 on Maryland. We'll keep you posted.
All right, Maryland had that big lead against Clemson last week and then ended up losing the game. Right now, NC State with a 14-7 lead. Michael Rocco back in there, alternating quarterbacks. Last time out, David Watford was in. His first pass was intercepted by Amerson. Harry Jones able to run around a couple of would-be tacklers for a first down.
Virginia finding a little more success, getting out on the edge, staying away from the inside power game. Anytime you're back and make a guy miss on the edge, this is the Virginia formula, positive yardage on first down.
Jones taking a break. Kevin Parks comes in to relieve him. Jones coming off a career-high 149 yards on the ground last week. State bringing pressure, and that pass was dropped by Parks as they tried to go underneath to him.
Terrell Manning getting in, breaking up the screen pass, running it on first down rather than a long yardage down. Normally, that's a Perry Jones play. Parks has been a little dinged up the last few weeks with a high ankle sprain. He's starting to get progressively healthier, and they're trying to work him more into the package.
Yeah, only three catches on the season for Parks. Jones, second leading receiver overall. Second and 10. Rocco hands it off to Parks, finds some running room. Down to the 44-yard line of NC State, picked up 8 before Brandon Bishop made the stop.
North Carolina State's answer to that unbalanced formation that Virginia likes to run is to bring some pressure off the outside, and they were able to get up underneath it there.
Clifton Richardson back into the backfield, one of three tailbacks we have seen for Virginia. Number 10 shifting now behind the quarterback. Richardson gets the handoff, puts his head down, and gets another Cavalier first down. Rashard Smith making the tackle. Richardson had a big 22-yard touchdown run in the upset over Georgia Tech last week. Touchdown catch today. First of his career. Inside 3 minutes to go in the first half. Take a look at what Virginia has done on offense.
Not a lot of shots downfield in play action thus far.
Here's one. And that one is thrown low and incomplete. Chris Byrd tried to get his hands underneath, but it's ruled incomplete.
Nice call by the official. Umpire in great position, saw that all the way. That's a good call.
Byrd, the leading receiver on this team, on the year, coming in with 31 catches, including two 100-yard receiving games this season. Second and 10, Rocco right back to the air, and that one was well defended. Rashard Smith was on the intended receiver, Tim Smith. Brings up a third and 10.
Deep sigh of relief there. Speed out. Rashard Smith jumping that route, narrowly missing that.
Smith also playing some wide receiver for NC State. Virginia has thrown 13 passes for only 36 yards and a Watford interception. Not getting it done through the air, but they do have that touchdown pass to Richardson. Rocco under duress, gets away from it, and then is taken down about 3 yards upfield by Audie Cole, the leading tackler for NC State. Kept going.
That was a scrum.
Yeah, see
that
where they're
going to scrum.
We're going to mark the football back at the 35-yard line. Rocco at 6'3", 225, trying to keep going. So here's a 4th and 5 from the 35. Mike London has decided to send out Robert Randolph to try a field goal. And this is going to be from about 52 yards out. Virginia has to run another lineman in there. Randolph's career long, by the way, 49 yards. So this would be a new career long for him. Timeout taken. Let's go back to the studio and Dari Noka.
Congratulations.
All right, Pam, coming up at the half, you get Matt Stinchcomb as well. You also get Clemson running up 59 points against North Carolina. Why, they look like they are for real. LSU, Auburn underway. Auburn hanging awfully tough and a Big Ten upset to tell you about. It's all coming up at the break.
All right, look forward to hearing from both Dari and, of course, Matt, his able sidekick back there in the studio right now. Mike London deciding to go for a 52-yard attempt, which would be a new career-long for the field goal kicker, Robert Randolph, who had a field goal block last week from just 32 yards away.
Be interesting if they might think fake at this point. This is a long shot. Their special teams has played pretty effectively, and I did watch our kickers in warm-ups, and they were hitting pretty good.
Wind doesn't appear to be too much of a factor. This is actually a concave bowl. The field is below ground level, so the wind is a little bit different on the field than it is up in the stands. And Rashard Smith is back at his six for NC State in case he can return something. They are kicking away. Randolph. Cannot get it to go through. Trying from 52 yards out would have been a new career long, but it faded just at the end. So now 1:42 left to go and three timeouts for the Pack.
Got into it pretty good. Just a little hook.
He was hoping. Senior from Naples, Florida. Second in Virginia career field goal percentage at about 79%. Mike Glennon, last two passes have been for touchdowns. This one to Stephen Howard, loses a yard. Cam Johnson making the tackle. Clock running, under a minute and a half to go.
Mike.
And they are in no hurry to get a playoff. Surprised by this?
Plenty of time left here. They may decide to try to get a first down. Normally when you have a negative play, the first play, maybe that changes your whole thinking.
All three of their timeouts remaining. The play clock is going to be below 5 seconds, right at five actually, as they snap it. And they decide to keep it on the ground. James Washington picked up a couple. Matt Conrath made the stop. ESPN, the home for passionate college football fans. Our experts break down the top schools in the nation in a weekly three-hour special. The experts on ESPNU Tuesdays at 1 and 7 Eastern. And that guy on the far right, that is one expert-looking expert. Our own Dan Hawkins. Fun show to do?
It's a great show. It's a combination of a lot of guys. It's fun to kick around a few opinions.
Dan Hawkins among those appearing on the experts this season. Here's a 3rd and 9 as NC State's going to be content. It appears to go in the locker room with this 7-point lead. Roy Reynolds making the stop on Washington. And with 15 seconds left, Virginia takes a timeout. Mike London trying to make something happen. Block punt would work wonders right now for the Cavaliers. Virginia trying to avoid a letdown after a big emotional win last week. They scored first, but NC State, after an interception, able to take the lead 14-7 in this game.
Virginia able to hit some shots last week in that first half, some throws downfield that really kind of keyed their emotions, not just only the scoreboard. They were not able to get that done in the first half.
Will Bauman in to attempt the punt. Dominique Terrell waits inside his 20. UVA with a valiant attempt to block it. Fair catch in traffic by Terrell. Bauman with a 31-yard punt with no return. Only 9 seconds left and one timeout. Let's see if Mike London, he's already got the headsets off. So that might indicate that they're not going to chuck one downfield.
North Carolina State has done a nice job controlling the run game for the most part, particularly the shots downfield, playing some man coverage, which is unusual for them, and that's where Mike Rocco's kind of had to run with the ball a little bit.
Yep, they're going to let the first half come to a close as well. Perry Jones, the tailback, ran for 149 yards last week, gets 1 yard on that carry for 42 in the half. So NC State with a couple of touchdown passes. Mike Glennon with an ACC leading 18 touchdown passes. Rocco has thrown one to Richardson. NC State up 14-7. Let's go to Dari for SportsCenter U.
Welcome to the All-State Game of the Week on ESPNU.
You are watching the ACC on ESPN. At the half, NC State is leading Virginia 14-7. Virginia coming off that upset win against Georgia Tech last week. Yes, it is the ACC on ESPN, and we have another good game for you brewing in Charlottesville. Pam Ward along with former Boise State and Colorado head coach Dan Hawkins. And Hawk, Virginia not really taking a lot of shots on offense, down by a touchdown.
Coach told us he wanted to get some easy completions, and right now only 36 yards passing, so they have got to get some pressure off that front and throw the ball downfield.
NC State has done a good job of throwing the ball downfield. Mike Glennon with two touchdown passes. Here are Dan Hawkins' second half adjustments.
Well, NC State had a plenty of plays downfield, hopefully with TJ Graham back in. That'll hit those shots. They're doing a great job on defense. Defensively, Virginia needs to mix it up against Mike Glennon.
TJ Graham is in there, second in the nation in all-purpose yards. Sat out the first half for disciplinary reasons. And he was over on the sidelines on a bike, trying to stay engaged, trying to get himself amped up. And he comes up with a 14-yard kick return. And there you see, did not play in the first half. A violation of team standards was what it was called, or not living up to NC State expectations. His punishment, sitting out the first half. And now we'll see if TJ Graham will be used as a weapon on offense, but he won't be for the first play because he's over on the sidelines. State also without the services of Tobias Palmer, a backup wide receiver, suffered a concussion in warmups. James Washington gets the carry, tackled by Matt Conrath after about a 1 yard gain. Washington picked up 44 yards in the first half. Mike Glennon, those numbers should be a lot better, coach, because he had three passes dropped in the first quarter.
Yeah, they had plenty of shots that they should have converted on. It'll be interesting to see in this second half if Jim Reed mixes it up. Normally they've been going with two high safeties to protect against the pass, but that's led to an effective running game.
And a couple of NC State players hurt on that last play, including the runner James Washington and RJ Mattis, the big left tackle, who is a junior now. And he is the son of Ron Mattis, who was an all-ACC defensive lineman here at Virginia and then had a great pro career on the offensive line. And you saw what just happened to Mattis as his leg got run into. And he limps off, has a couple of braces on his knees. Good to see him at least jogging off the field. Big guy at 6'6", 303. His dad was the offensive line coach for Virginia last year and has moved on to Elon College. Washington also going off. Rob Crisp, number 78, 6'7", 312, 312-pound sophomore, replaces Mattis now at the left tackle. And Tony Creasy, who caught a touchdown pass in the first half, replaces Washington at tailback. Second and eight for the Wolfpack. Coming in 3-3 on the year, 0-2 in the ACC. Glennon fires away. Short completion to Creasy, who just came into the game. Chase Minifield made the stop for Virginia after a 4 yard gain.
Good to see James Washington get back up and run off the field, because they can ill afford to lose yet another running back without the services of Mustafa Green.
And Curtis Underwood as well. Mustafa Green, their leading runner from a year ago, has not played at all this year and will not. And that pass was dropped. George Bryan, the tight end, on third and four, should have had a first down.
Pam. Tough. You know as a receiver that Mike Glennon's going to get the ball to you. He does a nice job checking it down, finds an open hole in there. Need to stay on the ground there. We're trying to jump, and the ball's coming in at the chest.
No tight end has more catches in the history of NC State football. That should have been another one for George Bryant. So instead of a first down, Bauman comes in to punt. Dominique Terrell, who has had some adventures as a punt returner this year, takes the fair catch. There was some contact. He was actually run into by his own man. The question was, did an NC State guy hit the Virginia guy, who then hit Terrell? 36-yard punt pending for Bauman.
There is no kick catch interference. The play was blocked. It's going to be first down, Virginia.
There was contact. Tyler Purvis gets pressure. It's basically Virginia on Virginia right there.
Trying to block away Taylor Gentry. And there's nothing doing on that play. Perry Jones ganged up on by Terrell Manning. Manning missed a couple of games, had surgery on a knee, got hurt against South Alabama earlier in the season. Back on the 17th of September, again, this NC State defense, we can't understate or overstate how many men they have lost. They have used seven different starting lineups on defense in this, their seventh game. 20 games already lost because of injuries on the defensive side. And that ball, that's a little miscommunication thrown behind the intended receiver, Tim Smith. Let's take a look at him. Terrell Manning, who at least is playing again, but J.R. Sweezy, the captain, broke a foot in fall camp, came back, tried to play, could not go, expected to be out for the rest of the season. Defensive end Jeff Rieskamp, starting at defensive end in the first game, got hurt, is done. Jarvis Byrd, projected to be the starting cornerback, and Lucas as well. Thomas Teal, who was a backup to a defensive lineman, also done for the year. So Tom O'Brien again saying he has never seen anything like it in all of his years in coaching, especially on the defensive side of the ball. Third and nine, State shows blitz. They bring one extra man. Rocco hit as he delivered, and that was dropped by Tim Smith. Something in the air in Charlottesville today, Dan.
Must be a thick fog we're not aware of. Pressure by Dwayne Maddox there. Doing a good job bringing five instead of four. Delivers the ball on time. Tim Smith unable to make the catch. He had a big play last week against Georgia Tech, but unable to come up with it there.
And there is TJ Graham getting ready to return the punt. Fair catch. Good high punt by Jimmy Howell, because you don't want Graham to return it. He's a threat to break it every time. 40-yard punt by Howell. NC State with the lead in the ball when we come back. Fans in Charlottesville watching their team trail NC State right now 14-7. Earlier today, the University of Virginia celebrated its national championship in men's lacrosse. They won it Memorial Day weekend, their fifth national title, and the young men were out on the field to be praised for somehow beating the University of Maryland in the final. Great athletic programs here at UVA. Congratulations to those young men for winning lacrosse. Great sport, fun sport. Fastest growing sport in America as far as participation for young men, for boys. Did you know that, Dan?
I think it's a great compliment to football particularly.
Yeah. On first down, Glennon on the boot. Throws it to James Washington. Washington actually the leading receiver, the most receptions of anybody on this team, as well as leading them in rushing this year. Picks up six. NC State down their top three rushers from last year. Mustafa Green, we talked about a little bit earlier, out with the foot injury. Their second leading rusher was that Russell Wilson guy, the quarterback who is now a Heisman candidate for the University of Wisconsin. Second and four for the Pack. Glennon with time, and it's intercepted by Rodney McLeod. Did he hold on to it? Yes. McLeod, the captain, one of the captains of this defense, coming up with the pick. T.J. Graham was the intended receiver.
Pressure over coverage, pocket collapsing. Jim Reed, defensive coordinator, said he had a couple of empty checks. He went to zone there, playing 4D, 3 under.
And an acrobatic catch for his first interception of the season for McLeod. At 5'11", undersized, certainly for a strong safety, but coming up with that great catch. Good starting field position again for Virginia at the 47. And that pass is intended for Kevin Parks, did not find the intended receiver. So let's see if Virginia decides to take some shots downfield, Coach. We haven't seen it from them.
Typically, this type of area, particularly when you get from the 50 to the plus 40, is a great time to take a shot. I think right now, Coach Laser for Virginia there, you see him on the sidelines. Very calm, poised, collected, intellectual, like this guy. Good positive energy from him, just trying to get some easy completions.
36 passing yards on the day for Virginia. Rocco, incomplete again. That thing was tipped away. Marcus Kuhn able to get a hand on it, and it's third and 10 just like that. Here's some boos cascading down from the fans here at Scott Stadium. They'd like to see him open it up a little bit.
They're living off that high of the win last week. Crowd rushed the field. It was a great moment for Coach London. Trying to get just a little bit of spark going here.
They led this game 7-0. Clifton Richardson catching a 6-yard touchdown pass from Michael Rocco, but they have done little on offense since. Third and 10. Rocco throws it to the NC State sideline. A 3-and-out for Virginia, and here are more boos from the crowd.
Are saying boos or who's?
I think they're
or the Wahoos.
They're saying, I think it's the B word, the boo word. So Jimmy Howell back into punt, and there is T.J. Graham. Seventh in the nation, first in the ACC, averaging 18.5 yards per punt return. And he decides to just let that one die. Inside the 20, Virginia says an NC State player touched it and it should be their football, but the officials are pointing towards the Wolfpack. Max Million, the fullback, was able to fall on it.
The ball will be put in play, first down.
So at the 17-yard line,
T.J. Graham right here, Pam. T.J. Graham has got to tell people to get away. You can't have your guys blocking involved. That's on the returner. Get guys away from there.
It almost hit Rodman Knoll. It did not, so it's NC State football. We'll take a quick timeout. We are back in Charlottesville. Mike London's team trailing NC State 14-7. They were hoping that they would be able to get the ball on this punt return, but these replays will show that it was close. But Rodman Knoll, number 5 for NC State, that ball just went right between his legs, did not touch it. So it was not a live football. Good call by the officials to keep it with NC State. Tony Creasy gets the carry for the Pack. Mike Glennon, whose first scholarship offer came from the University of Virginia. He is from Centerville, Virginia. His brother Sean was a very prolific quarterback at Virginia Tech, and this is his first year starting for State. Has thrown a couple of touchdown passes today. A little play action, though it didn't fool anybody. Completion for the first down. That's Jay Smith. First down Pack. Let's go back to Dari Noka.
All right, Pam, how about a record being set? Houston's Case Keenum came in within striking distance of Timmy Chang, the former Hawaii quarterback for the most passing yards in an FBS career. He is now near 17,000 as he has thrown for 171 today. He is the all-time record holder for FBS career passing yards.
Thank you, Dari. Both Timmy Chang and Case Keenum in those offenses where they just accumulate tons and tons of passing yards. Glennon giving it up to T.J. Graham, their playmaker, and the Virginia defense had that snuffed out. Graham dropped for a four-yard loss. Leroy Reynolds, a very active quarterback, or linebacker, excuse me, makes the play. Here are the undefeated teams that are remaining, 10 of them. Houston, who we just saw a highlight of with Case Keenum, they are one of them, as are the Boise State Broncos. LSU and Alabama going to play in a couple of weeks. Oklahoma State with a win today. They will play Oklahoma the first week of December in a what should be a huge bedlam game. Second and 14, Glennon slings it behind his intended receiver, Quentin Payton. Jim Reed, the defensive coordinator for Virginia, said that when we met with him that Glennon could throw the ball through a wall and there would be smoke coming out of the hole. That's how much zip this guy gets on the football. Got a heck of an arm.
This is a down and distance. With a normal quarterback, you might think, well, let's not try anything tricky here. But with Mike Glennon, a veteran, T.J. Graham back in the feet on the field, might try to throw for the first and be safe.
Retreating as he threw it, completed, but it will be well short of the first down. Quentin Payton with the catch, but Steve Greer was right there to lasso him. They got 6 yards, but needed about eight more. Cam Johnson came with good pressure on Glennon that time.
Certainly beneficial for Virginia getting some pressure without having to add a lot of defenders, because they need them to cover up and play deep, keep North Carolina State from taking those shots.
So on fourth and eight, Will Bauman, true freshman punter, in there yet again. Good penetration by Virginia, but couldn't get to it. And a fair catch taken by Dominique Terrell. Time for another update. Let's head back to the studio and Dari Noka.
All right, how about your AT&T All-America Player of the Week update? And it is Clemson quarterback Taj Boyd. Threw for 367 yards and 5 touchdowns. That ties a Clemson record in a 59-38 win over North Carolina. Clemson remains undefeated. You can text VOTE to 55862 from your mobile phone and for a chance at a trip to the national championship.
Thank you very much, Dari. Very impressive win for Clemson today over Carolina. First down play for Virginia. Perry Jones gets the carry, picks up 3 yards.
At some point here, Pam, Virginia's got to take advantage of the good field position. North Carolina State's been backed up most of the game. Virginia was in striking distance. They've got to be able to hit a play here, get a throw, get some momentum, get back in this game.
They had a terrific touchdown drive, their third drive of the day. 72 yards on 14 plays for 7.5 minutes. Their 7 other drives, just about a minute and 46 more, and not accumulating the yardage. One really good drive. The rest have been kind of iffy. That pass thrown a little bit behind Jones, who couldn't bring it in. And the grumbles continue from the fans here in Charlottesville. We are at Scott Stadium, All-State Game of the Week. NC State 3-3. Overall, 0-2 in the ACC, taking on 4-2 Virginia, a team that is coming off a huge win over previously unbeaten Georgia Tech. Pam Ward joined by Dan Hawkins. Michael Rocco threw a touchdown to Clifton Richardson back in the second quarter. Mike Glennon with a couple of touchdown throws for NC State. And Rocco has gone stone cold, hitting one of his last 11 throws. Blitz coming. Rocco got hit. And the pass is off the hand of Darius Jennings, but Rocco took a shot.
Coming off the edge, bringing 5, which they've been doing most of the games. Dante Johnson, 3-shot on the quarterback. David Watford might have to end up playing. We take too many of those shots.
Johnson, a sophomore from Pennington, New Jersey. The big hit and another Jimmy Howell punt. T.J. Graham says stay away from it, fellas. And it takes a Virginia roll. Rolls dead around the 17-yard line. Michael Rocco taking a big hit. His offense not doing a whole lot. We'll see what NC State can do when we come back.
If I can get free,
back in Charlottesville, where the score remains 14-7 in favor of NC State over Virginia. They have been backed up most of the way, losing the field position battle, but winning the game. Tony Creasy that time was dropped for a two-yard loss. Matt Conrad in on the tackle for this Virginia defense. Mike Glennon, the first-year starter for NC State.
Virginia doing a much better job stopping the running game this half, forcing North Carolina State to throw, and with the field position game, score still tight. North Carolina State has to be careful.
Glennon, another short pass. This time to Creasy, his running back, tackled by Taliaferro, picked up about 5 more yards. Another third down opportunity for NC State. They are 5 of 10 on third downs today. Coach Tom O'Brien looking down at the ground a little bit.
What we're seeing a little bit, Pam, it's not always exciting for the fans, and it's not a 45-50 game, but both coaches and both teams trying to make sure they want to win the game, but they also don't want to lose the football game, so need to be careful in these situations.
Third and 6, Glennon flushed out of the pocket. Boy, he had a man breaking downfield. Instead, went to T.J. Graham, who picked up only a yard. And here comes the punt unit again.
Credit to Virginia defense. Doing a great job turning the ball back over. Field position continues to be on the plus side for Virginia. Hopefully, if they can get one of these throws in here and get a little momentum, that'll jumpstart the Cavalier offense.
Will Bauman in yet again. To punt, Terrell waits inside his 40. That's a skyscraper. Terrell has to run up. Finally called for the fair catch. A lot of contact. And it's caught and down by an NC State player. Boy, as Terrell was running up after making the fair catch signal, he ran into some guys. David Amerson, who has an interception in this game, fell on the punt.
Kick catch interference on the kicking team. 15 yards from the spot of the foul. First down.
Really could have been his own guy again that time.
Yeah, that's a very fortunate call for the University of Virginia.
Tom O'Brien seeing it a little bit the same way, I think.
Yeah, I think they've shown it up on the big screen. DJ Hill ran into Terrell. They got Dante Johnson for NC State for making contact. And that's a 15-yard penalty. That's big. So Virginia with the football yet again. 6.5 minutes left to go in the third quarter. In this half, they already have 3 3 and outs. 9 plays, just 4 yards for this offense. Watford, the backup quarterback, in for the second time today, hands it off to Perry Jones, and Jones finds a little bit of running room before he is gang tackled over on the left side. And these are the drives we talked about. This is already their fourth possession, believe it or not, of the third quarter. And they have 4 yards, Coach.
Excellent field position. They need to maximize. Otherwise, just the negative momentum starts working against you. You have so many opportunities and you can't convert. That really gives a breath of life to the other team.
And they only had the ball. It took 2 minutes and 7 seconds for those 3 3 and outs. Let's see if Watford can kickstart them a little bit. He threw one pass in the first half and it was intercepted by Amerson, who leads the nation in that category. Here's his second pass of the game, perhaps. He can run. Throws it down the sidelines. It's caught, but well out of bounds was Darius Jennings. 3rd and 7. Jennings, one of the true freshman receivers, looking to get some more reps for Virginia.
I like getting David Watford out on the edge. Young quarterback, cleans up the reads a little bit. I think he's natural on the move.
Just 36 passing yards. Virginia's been stuck on that for a while. Virginia without the services of their captain, Matt Snyder, a receiver who broke his foot in practice on Tuesday and had surgery yesterday. So more impetus on the freshman receivers, and that's not going to work. What a play. Kevin Parks taken down by Art Norman, who just blew that play up. They lost six.
Just pressure inside stunt. Norman getting inside the block there in the zone, not be able to pick it up.
4 3 and outs in a row for Virginia, their fifth of the game. Norman, a redshirt freshman, pressed into action because of all of the injuries on the defensive line for State this year. Line drive punt that goes out of bounds by Howell, trying to keep it out of TJ Graham's hands. Went out of bounds around the 16-yard line. Only a 24-yard punt for Howell, who's getting a lot of practice today. Scores around the league today. Clemson with a couple of defensive touchdowns, wiping out North Carolina. Wake Forest barely beat Duke on the road. Tough year for Boston College. Georgia Tech falling for the second straight week. Now down a couple of touchdowns to Miami, and Florida State predictably up on Maryland. We will have North Carolina and Wake Forest next week in Chapel Hill for you, 3:30 Eastern on ESPNU. Should be an interesting game. James Washington. Maybe 3 yards on that play before Steve Greer made the tackle. Both teams scuffling on offense here in the third quarter. Dana Bible, the offensive coordinator for NC State, said his team really is not dominant in any particular phase. He said they have to do sort of like a lot of bobbing and weaving, figuring out defenses, playing to their strengths, NC State's strengths, to get anything accomplished, really. It helps to have Glennon at quarterback, who wisely throws it away because he was in a mess of trouble. Matt Conrath was right on top of him.
Virginia continuing to get pressure with only four guys.
Coming up Monday, Jesse Palmer and David Pollock provide an engaging and interactive look at this past week's actions, set the scene for the upcoming week's big games. ESPNU Mondays at 1 and 9 Eastern. College football lives here every day on ESPNU. And Glennon got up limping after he was hit by Conrath. There is Dana Bible. What a guy he is. He's been in remission for the last 16 months, suffering from leukemia, but in good shape and remission for a while. And what a veteran he has been. Glennon on the run, completes it. No, it's dropped again. NC State just can't hang on to the football, and that time it was their star, TJ Graham.
Is it the humidity in the air that we can't catch the football out here today?
I don't think it's that humid. It's got to be something else. Wow, right in the hands, and Graham, who's usually very reliable, couldn't bring it in. In this quarter, we have had 9 possessions between the two teams and 1 first down. Ballman, his turn to punt. Fair catch. Terrell makes it cleanly this time. Let's get to Dari Noka. Dari, we got a heck of a lot of punting going on here, buddy.
Well, how about a Sports Center right now, Pam? It's presented by Discover Card. Taj Boyd ties a Clemson school record with 5 touchdown passes. They beat North Carolina 59-38 to remain unbeaten. They visit Georgia Tech next week. Houston quarterback Case Keenum has broken former Hawaii quarterback Timmy Chang's FBS career record for total offense. The Houston quarterback over 17,000 yards as they lead Marshall.
What a career for Case Keenum. We've had 8 punts in the third quarter. Will Virginia make it 9? They will if they keep that up. Perry Jones dropped by Wayne Crawford for a 4-yard loss.
Virginia needs to take advantage of great field position. Block it up. Take one of those shots down the field. Try to get a big play and ignite your offense here.
And look who's back in at quarterback. It's Watford. So alternating quarterbacks. Virginia says they do it on a field basis. Bill Lazor, the offensive coordinator, and Mike London, the head coach, decide who to put in. A little bit of room this time for Jones. Picks up about 3, so it's going to bring up a About a third and 10. Dwayne Maddox made the stop. Maddox made the stop, made the start, excuse me, at the Sam linebacker because DJ Green couldn't go, hurt his abdomen in practice. So yet another defensive player for NC State nicked up.
Well, they talked about they moved fullback Taylor Gentry to D-line, and he got hurt as well. So,
yep.
Plenty of guys banged up there.
Can't win for losing. So Watford facing a third and 10. He's 0 for 2 through the air. Has time to throw, and it is almost intercepted. Tim Smith was the intended receiver, but Earl Wolf, there you see him, got a hand on it for the Pack. Here comes our ninth punt of the quarter. That's got to be a record or something.
Well, the fans are not liking this, but both coaches are definitely making sure they're not going to lose the football game right now. So they're trying to wait, break service a little bit in here somewhere. Bad field position for North Carolina State.
Jimmy Howell with his fifth punt of the quarter on Virginia's fifth three and out of the quarter. They don't want Graham to touch it. Rolls dead at the 20. ESPN News coverage of college football continues tonight as Trent Steelman leads the Army Black Knights against Jack Stacy and the Commodores of Vanderbilt. College football primetime presented by 5-Hour Energy on ESPNU tonight. Catch it at 7 Eastern time. Zach Stacy, the running back for Vanderbilt, James Franklin's team. 10th in the SEC in rushing, averaging over 6.5 per carry. Catch him tonight. Vandy and Army, always fun to watch these service academies play and run the option.
They play hard. They play hard every down.
And you know they're in top shape as well. Oh, there's some contact. No penalty, though, as James Washington kind of ran into Taliaferro, the linebacker. Second and 10. Neither team has done anything on offense in this quarter. 9 punts in this quarter.
North Carolina State opening up with a throw this time rather than a run. Try to catch Washington down the sideline on a little wheel route against Taliaferro, the linebacker, but unable to connect.
Lennon flings one to the Virginia sideline in the vicinity of Brian Underwood, third and 10.
Neither quarterback able to get in a rhythm. Unable to find, like a pitcher sometimes or a batter, you've got a shooter in basketball, you got to get into a rhythm of anticipation and trajectory, and a little bit of pressure's thrown Mike Lennon off and not able to come up with some catches and key points.
Third and 10 now for the Pack. Four-man rush. They run a stunt up front and a caught pass and a first down. And Brian Underwood is off to the races. Underwood all the way in for the NC State touchdown. That is a 79-yard touchdown for the Pack.
Dom Joseph unable to come up with a tackle. Tremendous athletic ability, staying in bounds and speed.
Second touchdown catch of the game for Underwood. Sadie adds the extra point. So we had no offense in the third quarter. 9 punts between the two teams, and on third and 10, Glennon hits Underwood, a missed tackle later. He's in the end zone.
Big-time players make big-time plays and big-time games, and you've got to have a guy come up with something. Credit Underwood, had a few struggles early in the game and breaks a tackle and house call.
Look at the speed for Underwood, a redshirt freshman from Ohio, outside of Cleveland. And relief, certainly, for NC State. Their offense has been bottled up in the second half. So too has Virginia's. And they lead the Cavaliers 21-7. Two incompletions, two quick incompletions, and then the 79-yard strike for a 19-second scoring drive. Second touchdown catch of the game for Underwood, the first two of his career.
I think Coach Tom O'Brien is saying, that was a great play, that was awesome, but the little celebration in the end zone, not really what we're all about here.
There was no flag for that celebration, and now with the new rule being enforced this year, if you celebrate, say if he were to do that at the 5-yard line, they would have taken the touchdown away.
Yeah, they deem it as taunting.
Yes.
Which is a good rule.
Sadie with the kickoff. Another low line drive. That's going out of bounds. Oh, that's not good. And some extra scuffling around the 35-yard line after the play between a couple of Cavs and an NC State player, Logan Winkles, the backup fullback.
By the kicking team. Ball be placed at the 40-yard line. First down.
So the ball goes to the 40-yard line. Good field position for Virginia. Let's see if they can do something with it. Let's go back to Dari.
All right, let's update out of the ACC. Florida State hosting Maryland, and it's already a 17-3 lead for the Noles. Jermaine Thomas goes 34 yards, and Florida State firmly in control up at home 24-3.
Thank you, Dari. And updated standings, Clemson 5-0 in the Atlantic Division, 8-0 overall. Now you see NC State trying to get its first ACC win of the year. They're up 21-7. Watford is still in there. Here's your shot downfield to Tim Smith. He's got it! Touchdown, Virginia! A 60-yard scoring play for the Cavaliers.
Opening up with some great play action. Max protection, only two guys in the route. Getting that ball out there. Tim Smith over top of Rashard Smith.
David Watford. Yep. Keeping him in there because Michael Rocco had hit only one of his last 12 throws before he was replaced a couple of series ago. Randolph's extra point. And after 9 punts to begin the third quarter on back-to-back offensive plays, you have a 79-yard pass from Glennon to Underwood for State and a 60-yard pass, Watford to Smith for Virginia.
Almost as importantly, you got this Wahoo crowd back into the game and fired up and get that home field advantage going.
Perfectly thrown ball, good coverage downfield. Before that play, Virginia had run 15 plays in the third quarter for a grand total of 1 yard.
That's why the game's 60 minutes long, Pam. 60 minutes long. Play, tell, but zeros all the way across the board.
60-yard touchdown pass, and you're right. The crowd back into it. They were surly. The offense had done nothing in the third quarter. They fell behind 21-7. And now Mike London's team is right back in this thing. Chris Hinkebein in to kick off. TJ Graham waits at the goal line.
Be interesting to see if Mike Glennon back in rhythm and Coach O'Brien feeling comfortable with it, if they open it up and get back throwing it, even though they might be backed up again.
A kick to Graham this time at the 5. TJ Graham, one of the best return men in the country, goes all the way across the field, but is taken out around the 29-yard line by Anthony Harris, a true freshman. But a 23-yard return for TJ, who was second in the history of the ACC in kick return yards behind Torrey Smith from Maryland, who now plays for the Ravens in the NFL. So let's see what they do with Glennon.
And this is some outstanding field position for North Carolina State in this game.
Their average start has been at the 23 before this possession, and here they are all the way out at the 28-yard line. Glennon underneath, great play. Creasy taken down by Steve Greer, the middle linebacker, for a 5-yard loss.
Again, only rushing 4. Pressure on Glennon, forcing them to go to the screen game. sniffed out by Steve Greer. Still playing two high safeties, soft corners, trying to make sure we don't get beat over the top for the Cavaliers.
And most of the fans standing and cheering on second and 14. Four-man rush, Glennon in trouble. He's got to throw it away, and he does. Stephen Howard was the closest Wolfpack player to the ball.
You have to love the enthusiasm and the energy of college football, the home field advantage, the kids on the sideline getting the crowd going. Not a lot of action for a while, and then all of a sudden, fireworks.
Yeah, they were very surly, lots of boos here, the offense doing nothing. But that terrific 60-yard pass play, Watford to Smith, and now the defense has a third and 14.
North Carolina State not afraid to throw for a first down here with Mike Glennon.
Certainly has the arm for it. But they throw underneath again. That's not going to get it done. Stephen Howard taken down by Leroy Reynolds. And a good stop for Virginia. Decent field position for State, but a three and out after the Virginia touchdown.
Nice job of Mike Glennon managing the game. As much excitement as there is in the stadium, they still have a seven-point lead. No need to get careless with a football backed up in your own territory.
Bauman for another punt. Terrell waits around his 30. Another short one. Terrell has gotten into trouble sometimes this year, picking up bouncy punts. But at that time, he was able to advance it about 10 yards after the 48-yard punt by Bauman.
Pam, every time that ball hits the ground, it's going to be average out to be a 19-yard loss for you. So you don't want to be careless scooping it, but that guy needs to catch the football right there.
And that is a statistical, something that was proven statistically, right? There was a research done into that.
I've charted it.
It's been charted. David Watford is still out there, a quarterback, as you would expect. Threw a touchdown pass last time, and Perry Jones, that's a big hole over that left side. And he gets it up to the 40, picks up seven. Terrell Manning made the stop for the Pack.
Virginia's had a lot more success getting that ball outside than up inside like they did last week. And for whatever reason, I think they've been more successful to the left side as well.
Virginia with 99 rush yards today. They were spectacular last week. 274 rushing yards, actually outgaining Georgia Tech on the ground. As a very interesting third quarter comes to an end. There were nine punts to begin the third quarter. And then Mike Glennon hit Brian Underwood from 79 yards out. Underwood breaking a tackle, and then Tim Smith catching one from 60 yards away. It's 21-14. Fourth quarter about to get underway. Let's go back to the first half. Virginia got on the board first. Michael Rocco to Clifton Richardson from 6 yards out. And then Mike Glennon hit Tony Creasy from 5 yards away. And then David Amerson, leading the nation in interceptions, got another one. Then Glennon with his beautiful strike, 79 yards to Brian Underwood. Actually, that was a 33-yard play. This is the 79-yard play because of the broken tackle. Underwood kept his feet. NC State went up 21-7 on the next offensive play for Virginia. David Watford to Tim Smith, perfectly thrown for the 60-yard score. It's 21-14. And before those back-to-back big plays, the third quarter was offensively repugnant. Perry Jones with the carry. Let's take a look at today's game track brought to you by Taco Bell. A wild third quarter. Michael Rocco has given way to David Watford, who has thrown an interception, but that big touchdown. And Mike Glennon has been the victim of about four drops, but still has three touchdowns throw for NC State. Glennon has thrown 19 touchdown passes on the season, which leads the Atlantic Coast Conference. Virginia with the football. David Watford, we expect him to go the rest of the way. Quarterback keeper, this is the difference. One of the differences between him and Rocco is he can run that play. First down.
Mobile quarterback makes it tough on your coverage. It's tough to play man coverage. Pam, I think one of the things that Virginia is trying to do is go left. Ode Abouche and Austin Patster going against Ty McGill and Daryl Cato Bishop. A little size and experience advantage over here on the left side for Virginia.
McGill out there as a true freshman. Watford rolling out, taking a shot downfield and overthrows Darius Jennings, a true freshman receiver. But they have aired it out since Watford has come into the game, something they were not doing with Rocco in there.
Certainly helps the running game when you make the defensive secondary play off. They can't cheat. And it's a shot, really, that does you no harm because you're throwing it only where your guy can get it.
The 96 passing yards for Virginia, 60 of them coming on Watford's touchdown toss to Tim Smith. Second down, Richardson, who caught the first touchdown pass today. Only picked up about a yard. Dwayne Maddox made the stop for the Pack.
Virginia continuing to go with that outside running game, feeling like they've got a little bit of an edge at tackle. Expect probably a screen down here. I don't think you want to put David Watford at too much of a risk. He got great field position. Screen pass, dump pass.
Phil Lazor, the offensive coordinator. See what he's dialing up on third and eight. Watford, can he escape? No, he cannot. Great containment by Dwayne Maddox to get the elusive. David Watford down after no gain.
Virginia did try to squeak out Kevin Parks to the right side late, but was covered nicely.
And Jimmy Howell coming back out to punt for the Cavaliers. TJ Graham standing at his 10. See what kind of strategy they take with Howell, because they don't want Graham to return it. He tries to cough and corner it. And he does, but it just skips into the end zone. NC State will have the ball at the 20 after the 40-yard punt, but just the 20-yard net. Virginia trailing NC State. The Pack have the football when we come back to Charlottesville. NC State with the ball, leading Virginia 21-14 as we take a look at our good hands play brought to you by Allstate. And we take you back to the second quarter. Mike Glennon, first of three touchdown passes. This one to Brian Underwood. Long score from 33 yards out. Underwood also has caught a 79-yard touchdown pass, and Glennon's looking to pass again. Going down the middle and just off the left hand of TJ Graham. They're trying to get him involved in this offense. Graham did not play at all in the first quarter, in the first half. Being disciplined by Tom O'Brien.
Up against freshman Demetrius Nicholson. He gave up the first touchdown to Underwood.
Graham could not bring it in. He has touchdown catches of 63, 67, and 87 yards this season, but has not gotten a catch yet today. Back to the running game, and Creasy, who's dragged down by Billy Shouts after a three-yard gain, so a third and seven coming up for the Wolfpack.
Credit the defensive line for Virginia in this second half, getting pressure on Glennon with only four rushers, and then doing an excellent job in the run game as well.
Third down as the noise increases. Over the middle, big hit, and it's intercepted. Corey Mosley stepped in front of the receiver, Quentin Payton, and comes up with it.
North Carolina State Going four verticals there. This is one Mike would love to have back. Free safety standing there in the middle of the field. Needs to see the secondary shell on that kind of a route. You can see his head tilted a little bit towards the left there. I don't think he had full vision of the secondary.
Second interception this half thrown by Glennon. Can Virginia take advantage? Going over the left side of the line again, but not much real estate there. Terrell Manning taking down Perry Jones. But what an interception by Mosley, the senior from Richmond, Virginia, which is the hometown of head coach Mike London as well. And Watford continues to be the quarterback for the Cavaliers.
Yeah, North Carolina State, let's give them credit too, Pam. As much injuries as they've had up front, they've done a nice job controlling the running game for Virginia.
Second and nine, Parks in at running back now. He gets it. Taken down in the backfield. No, he escaped. How did he get out of there? Parks with a tremendous job to pick up 5 yards when it looked like he was going to be dropped for a loss.
Off tackle play, just missed tackles. Penetration by Brian Slay, but unable to make the tackle. Great opportunity right here to take advantage of David Watford's legs. Quarterback draw, or even an opportunity for the quarterback to run on some sort of a sprint out action.
On third and four, Virginia 5 for 14 on third downs. And that included going 4 for 4 on one drive. They've really struggled since that beautiful 70-yard drive that they had, 72-yard drive very early in the second quarter, and they don't convert this time. Cole coming up with another stop.
You're gonna go. Good call. Good advanced planning by the Virginia staff. If he thinks it's two down territory, go ahead and run the ball on third down, knowing you're gonna come back and go for it anyway on fourth. That's good strategy by Mike London.
Fourth and three, and they're doing it with the true freshman quarterback, Watford, out there. Parks, his tailback. Pressure coming from NC State. The pass is incomplete, going for a quick slant to Perry Jones, but he was well covered by C.J. Wilson.
North Carolina State opting to bring six guys. There's two outside backers and the four defensive linemen. Reading that hot, going to a slant route. Perry Jones is a running back, probably runs that some, probably not as much as a wide receiver. That's why just a little bit off.
Mike Archer, the defensive coordinator, coming up with the pressure. And the ball goes over on downs to NC State. Virginia leading in rushing yards this afternoon, but well down in passing yards. Mike Glennon has thrown three touchdown passes, but two interceptions for NC State. Virginia with a couple of touchdown passes today. They had an ACC low five touchdown passes coming into this game.
Coach Tom O'Brien getting the big uglies over there in a huddle. He wants these guys to take over this game right now, get the running game going, give Mike Glennon an opportunity to throw the football, particularly against a four-man rush.
O'Brien in his fifth year in charge of the NC State Wolfpack, coming off a year last year in which they had 9 wins, including a bowl win over West Virginia. They expected good things this season, but a lot of injuries on defense. They lost their top three rushers from last year. Starting quarterback Russell Wilson, gone. He was their second leading rusher last year behind Mustafa Green, who was out, has been out all year with a hurt foot. And this would be huge if they could hang on here on the road at Virginia. Still looking for their first ACC win of the season. And there you see a bit of a rough start taking over for Chuck Amato. And they thought they had everything turned around last year, but trying to overcome huge obstacles this season.
Tom O'Brien's teams continue to get better, not only during games, but during seasons. They have a very experienced staff. Coach O'Brien loses very few coaches every year, tremendous amount of continuity. They keep working on what they do, continue to perfect it, and do those things well. That's why they improve in games and in the season.
did a terrific job at Boston College, more wins than any coach in the history of BC. Let's see if that offensive line does respond to Tom O'Brien. James Washington, the running back, gets the handoff and gets a couple of yards downfield. We asked Tom O'Brien earlier this week about the season so far. He said he was disappointed but not discouraged in what has happened. Disappointed in the obstacles they've had to overcome, but still hoping that things are looking up for them. Mike Lennon is junior, so he'll have him back next year at quarterback. And hopefully, for his sake and NC State fans' sake, get some guys healthy out there. Second and eight. Glennon gets rid of it, and it is caught by TJ Graham. That is his first catch of the day, and it's very close to the first down. They're going to measure. Graham, again, if you're just joining us, was not allowed to play in the first half, being disciplined.
Virginia continuing to play a bunch of cover two with two deep safeties. Free safety Corey Mosley and Roddy McLeod defending against those deep passes. Credit the front of Virginia for taking care of the run game. So now they're trying to work on some of those alley defenders, which ends up being your outside linebacker against a TJ Graham, who's a little more athletic.
You can see by the spot that they were going to be short, and they measured anyway. TJ Graham averaging 23 yards per catch coming into this game. Able to come up with, check that, his second catch of the game today. Fourth in the nation in average. Third and inches. And the crowd cheers on its defense. Time of possession, in case you're wondering, just about dead even in this game. NC State runs for it and gets the first down. That's James Washington, the junior from Orlando, coming in with back-to-back 100-yard games. A little tougher sled of it today with only 55, but that was a big first down.
That's where you'd love to have their fullback, Taylor Gentry. You could get your power running game going, but with the injuries, tough to have that in your arsenal.
Gentry with a hurt ankle. Senior from Raleigh, a former walk-on. They're missing him back there. Glennon takes off. A little shovel pass. He was very close to the line of scrimmage, but Smith caught it and got close to another first down.
Coach London is not liking that. Great heads-up play. Doesn't matter how you throw it. Now keep in mind, the quarterback's body has to be entirely across the line of scrimmage in order for this to be downfield. If even a partial bit of his body is on the line or behind it, it's still a good pass.
And indeed, that's what it was. It was an ugly pass, but a good and effective pass. A little two-handed underhand shovel. And on first down, right back to James Washington, who maybe picks up a yard for State, who would love to hang on to this football for a while.
Little bit of an irony from last week, where Virginia ran out the clock with almost 6 minutes left to go. We've got over 7 minutes here.
Virginia beating Georgia Tech 24-21 last week. Got the ball with 5 minutes and 58 seconds left to go in the fourth quarter and ran out the clock. Got into the victory formation inside the red zone, which kind of messed up that statistic a little bit, but it was an impressive drive when they needed it most, and State wants one of those now. Washington down to the 40. ESPNU, the home for passionate college football fans, as our experts break down the top schools in the nation in a weekly three-hour special. Don't miss any of the unfiltered conversation about the hot topics of college football on the experts. ESPNU Tuesdays at 1 and 7 Eastern Time. Third and four.
Another possibility for going four downs here. possible run, knowing that you go for it on fourth down.
They're passing, and it's too high for the intended receiver, Steven Howard. At 6'2", he was unable to bring it in, so let's see what they do on fourth and four. It's the punter.
Good play call. Got him there. Mike just delivers a little bit high.
Bombing in to punt it. Chase Minifield back to return the punt. We saw him back there last week. Did not get his hands on it. He will not get his hands on this one. And that's terrific coverage by NC State. Bauman with the pop-up punt. And how about Scott Thompson, the long snapper, catching it? Sun is setting in Charlottesville, Virginia. Virginia trailing NC State 21-14 with 6:19 left in the fourth. Pam Ward along with Dan Hawkins. And a big punt by Will Bauman popped it up, and his long snapper, another true freshman, Scott Thompson, hustled down there. Thompson at 6 feet tall, 220, hustled all the way down there, and now Virginia's backed up at the four-yard line. True freshman quarterback David Watford still in there, and he throws it at the feet of his intended receiver, Darius Jennings. Watford getting all the quarterback play since he came in and threw a 60-yard touchdown, and we also saw Michael Rocco struggling mightily in the second half.
Well, and he took a few hits there. That might be part of the reason. Virginia has to be careful down here. I think it's good getting David Watford on the move. Don't do anything here dangerous. Put your team, plenty of time left, timeouts left. Be smart with the football.
Rocco on the sidelines looking on. Throwing from his end zone, and it is intercepted. David Amerson with his second interception of the game takes it in for the touchdown after Tim Smith bobbled it.
Coach has talked about Amerson's ability to make plays. This ball should have been caught by Tim Smith. Ricochets up. Amerson, great ball skills. And a little bit of hops right there to get it in.
Amerson leading the country with 8 interceptions. His second pick of the day. That's going to go on Watford's record, obviously. But you're right, Tim Smith should have made that catch. But Amerson, the ball skills, one of these guys that's always around the ball. And he got it, took it in for the score. And that could do it for Virginia in this game. Timeout taken by NC State. Tim Smith couldn't get it done. David Amerson did. We are back at Scott Stadium, where some of the Virginia faithful, if you want to call them that, are leaving the building with 6:08 left to go after the interception return for a touchdown has given NC State a 14-point lead after Sadie's extra point.
Mike London trying to build something very special here at Virginia. Great crowd last week. Love to see the fans hanging here. And I know this seems like a game's not over. And believe it or not, I've seen 16 points scored in 20 seconds before. So I've seen it all.
A lot of the folks deciding to head to the exits a little bit early, with Virginia now down by 2 touchdowns. Let's go back to Amerson, but Tim Smith just didn't bring this one in.
Tough break. That interception goes against David Watford, but it was a curl flat route. Delivered on time. Amerson doing a good job crowding that route and scoring with the football.
Huge turnover. Amerson leading the nation in interceptions with 8. He has 2 today. Both of the turnovers ending up in his hands. One a direct score, and the other one, NC State scored on the first offensive play after Amerson's first interception.
And we talked about it, Pam. You'd love to go for it, launch it, get aggressive, but young team, you don't want to lose the game. Sometimes that happens when you start throwing a football.
Sadie's kick. Kalik Shepard breaking free. Backup running back out to around the 41-yard line, taken down by Amerson, the intercepting machine. ESPN News coverage of college football continues tonight. Trent Steelman and Army take on Zach Stacy and Vandy. College football primetime presented by 5-Hour Energy on ESPNU tonight at 7 Eastern time.
Virginia needs to be a little bit more aggressive here, but they can still score in 3 minutes. They've got three timeouts left. You make it a 21-28 game. You go for it. Or kick an onside kick and get the ball, you got opportunities. Coach Lazor is going to have to open up the playbook a little bit, but he doesn't have to start taking shots way down the field. It's not desperation time.
And they're keeping Watford out there, four wide receivers, and the true freshman completes it. First down, that's Chris Bird. He's been eerily quiet today. 12 yards, picks up the first down. That's only his second catch of the afternoon. UVA trying to save some time, going no huddle. Down by two touchdowns. Watford taken down. Flag comes down behind the play. Marcus Kuhn getting in on the sack. Hold against the Cavaliers.
Holding. Offense number 68. 10-yard penalty. First down.
Anthony Mahota, the center, backs him up 10 yards. Quarterback comparisons. Both Michael Rocco and David Watford have played. Rocco had a pretty good start, but then really cooled off. And then Watford came in through the 60-yard touchdown, but also a couple of interceptions.
Yeah, unfortunately, that last one wasn't necessarily his fault.
Brings it down, still looking for a receiver. And then it's thrown, and it's not intercepted because he ran out of bounds. They said he threw it when he was on the sideline. He was being pursued by Kuhn.
So what happens when you have freshmen in the game trying to make a play. Just needs to know he's going to have two more downs here. And if he throws it, that's okay. Throw it where your guy's not going to get it. But throwing it late back that way, you're asking for problems.
They lost 2 yards, so it's a second and 22 for Virginia. Watford. Boy, he had a man. Jennings had some separation down there, but the pass was offline. Third and 22.
North Carolina State playing cover two on the down. Did have a flag route breaking open as the safety fell down. David just needs to understand he needs a couple of completions here. Doesn't have to go for it all on third down here.
Here comes the blitz from NC State. Watford escaped. Completed it to Bird, and Bird fumbles the ball out of bounds right around the 40. They're a couple of yards short of the first down, and you figure they have to go for it. It's a big 20-yard gain.
North Carolina State switching it up, bringing pressure from the outside. Mobile quarterback able to avoid some of that. Extend the play. Is he coming right off the edge? A little pressure. David, nice job stepping up and delivering the football.
Ball popped out, but fortunately for Virginia, it went out of bounds. And they're calling it, they've marked it at the 30, at the 41, excuse me, so it's a fourth and three. Watford has another pass intercepted. It went off Bird's hands. Brandon Bishop this time. Three interceptions for the NC State defense. And an 18-yard return for Bishop. His second interception in as many games.
Again, ball coming off of Chris Bird. Ball's out in front just a little bit. Brandon Bishop right there to make the play. This whip route was completed earlier in the game. Was a nice little play against zone coverage. North Carolina State bringing six on that play and in man.
Fourth interception of the year by Bishop. Flag down as Washington gets a healthy game.
Credit North Carolina State coming here on the road. TJ Graham, their best playmaker, sits down for the first half. Numerous injuries, beat up front on defense, did a great job controlling the Virginia running game.
David Watford with as many interceptions as completions, but two of those three interceptions were off the hands of Virginia receivers.
It's a 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down.
Holding against NC State, so negate that game. And you have to wonder, as Virginia gets ready next week, and you know, this is a really short week. What a time to have a short week. They play at Miami on Thursday night. Who's your quarterback? Who do you start? They've been going with two QBs, but Watford got most of the playing time in the second half today.
Coach London talked about this, that the two quarterback system was in question before. Then it was great last week. Now it'll be back in question again this week.
The up and down, ups and downs of being a coach, being a fan. Rocco finished one for his last 12 today. That's why he was yanked. And then Watford threw the long touchdown pass. Washington with another carry. Greer with another tackle. We get another Dari Noka.
Which is probably one too many, Pam. Don't forget, coming up top of the hour, Jordan Rodgers, younger brother of Aaron Rodgers, making his first career start as Vanderbilt hosts Army.
Oh, come on. There can never be enough Dari Noka. And another Rodgers out there? Oh, my goodness. His big brother Aaron's done pretty good things with Green Bay. We look forward to that. And a short week coming up for the Virginia Cavaliers. Lots of things to do before they play Miami. And lots of decisions to be made, including who's your guy at quarterback. Washington with another run, taken down around the 45. So Virginia coming into this game, the big question was how would they respond to the upset win over unbeaten and at that time 12th ranked Georgia Tech. Since 2005, 2-4 after defeating a ranked team, and they are 3 minutes and 38 seconds to dropping to 2-5. And sometimes growing pains, I guess you could say, with teams that haven't won a lot recently. How do you handle success? And Virginia not handling NC State, down 14. We're going to take a quick timeout and head back to Charlottesville. ESPNU College Football All-State Game of the Week. Brought to you by Allstate. Shop less, get more. Make one call to an Allstate agent. We are back in Charlottesville, where the University of Virginia is trailing NC State 28-14. That's a look at the UVA offensive line. Virginia led this game 7-0 and has not led since. Mike Lennon with three touchdown passes. Hand off to James Washington on 3rd and 14, and he comes up short. David Amerson with an interception for a touchdown, accounting for NC State's scores. The Wolfpack with three interceptions on the day. Let's take a look at them. David Amerson came into this game leading the nation in picks and got two more today. That was a brilliant pick. One play later, a touchdown for NC State. This was a direct touchdown as Amerson was able to get it off the hands of Tim Smith. And another tip ball, this time to Brandon Bishop, his fourth pick of the year. NC State, this defense is banged up and nicked up as they are, as young as they are. They really have taken advantage of takeaways. They lead the ACC in takeaways. And they have 21 of them on the season now. And this young man leads the entire country with eight picks.
Pretty athletic. Both of those plays were not gimmies. He had to go get them.
Ballman into punt. Terrell back at his 10. Full-time pressure, big-time pressure by Virginia. They don't get to it. Terrell wisely calls for the fair catch and then dropped it. NC State picked up the football. It was Earl Wolf. This game, seen a lot of this today.
This is what's called a muff. Cannot advance a muff. That ball would have hit the ground. It would have become a fumble. So it's North Carolina State ball right there.
And we told you that Terrell has struggled in the punt return game this season. We saw Minifield back there earlier in the game. He was their primary punt returner last year. And things kind of falling apart for Mike London's team this afternoon. NC State gets the ball right back with just 3:22 left to go in the game, and we anticipate them keeping it on the ground. James Washington with the carry that time. Picked up four. Let's go back to Dari in the studio.
All right, guys, how about Casey Hayward and Vanderbilt? This is a team that forces turnovers. Army certainly have their work cut out for them. Vandy and Army coming up, but we're like 17 minutes away from kicking off.
All right, we'll see you there. Casey Hayward with five interceptions. Oh, that's nothing. Amerson. Amerson, the guy we have here, he's got eight. Season high in rushing last week against Georgia Tech. Just 124 today for Virginia. 126 yards through the air, so just 250 yards of offense for the Cavs. And 60 yards came on one play. A touchdown pass from Watford to Tim Smith. Here's the schedule coming up. A Thursday night game on ESPN. They rebound. They have to rebound quickly and take on Miami.
Be a short week. They're going to have to flush this and move on, learn from it. Coach London's down there pleading with his guys to finish this football game.
Another carry for Washington, and they did not look at the game tape last week against Georgia Tech because they knew it would not be relevant. They played a triple option team, totally different team today in NC State. And you have to give NC State a lot of credit coming in on the road without their star playing for the first half. TJ Graham, who was disciplined for conduct that was considered not to be living up to NC State's expectations. This will be their first win in the ACC. And they will be next week at Florida State, North Carolina. That's what they have the rest of the way. They have to win after today three more games to be bowl eligible. They need seven wins this year because two of their wins have come against FCS schools, the former 1AA schools that don't count towards your bowl eligibility. Washington taken down by Leroy Reynolds.
The runner was down, fourth down.
Yep, Nicholson came up with the ball, but as Brad Allen tells us, the ball was dead.
Virginia without timeouts.
Did you ever use a two quarterback system?
I have, and I don't like it.
You just did it out of necessity, or?
Just sometimes you get in a situation, it's just one guy doesn't separate from the other, and it's difficult, but it's not fun. It's not fun for the guys, and it's not fun for the coaches.
And on fourth down, Virginia gets it back. Good penetration by Matt Conrad to get Tony Creasy. You know, when your son played for you at Colorado, there were a couple of quarterbacks there, right? I recall.
Yeah.
But this here at Virginia, I mean, this is, and we've seen it, you know, you see it at different places. At Penn State, it's not working this year. They designed two quarterback system, and you just have to wonder if you got to just say, hey, Watford's a true freshman. Let's go all in with this guy. But they're still trying, obviously, to win football games and get to a bowl game. So it's a kind of a sticky situation. But the critics who weren't there last week because they beat Georgia Tech, they're going to be up in arms again this week after this performance.
I think you hit it on the nail, Pam. There's so much pressure to win every single game that sometimes it's hard to develop or it's hard to look past. Well, maybe it wasn't just the quarterback. It was the O-line or the receivers. And so there's just a lot of urgency and immediacy on who's playing quarterback and how well he's playing.
Flag is down. Watford completes to Chris Bird. But the quarterbacks always get all of the attention, or most of the attention.
Illegal formation foul. More than four players in the backfield on the offense. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
Mike Glennon, meanwhile, three more touchdown passes today. So he has, on the season, 19 touchdown passes. leading the ACC in that category. Having a spectacular year as a first-year starter. Taking a shot downfield towards Jennings, another true freshman, and that's incomplete.
You can see David Watford can spin it. He has arm strength, good control, can turn the ball over. Just needs experience.
And if you're thinking, boy, Glennon looks tall, you're right. He's 6'6 over there. Second tallest in the Bowl subdivision. Younger brother of Sean Glennon. His confidence is up. They really like him. His game management is getting better, and Tom O'Brien says he's going to be a heck of a quarterback one day. Another errant pass. Ray Keyes, the intended receiver that time. We are now inside a minute. Michael Rocco. Rough game today for him after a relatively good start. Finishes 7-for-19 for only 36 yards. Did have a touchdown, but was only 1-for-his-last-12 through the air.
Coach Dana Bible has seen a lot of great quarterbacks. He thinks Mike Glennon compares with all of them.
Watford hit as he threw, and it's low towards Chris Bird. Brings up a 4th and 16. Marcus Kuhn with another hit on Watford. That was the fourth down play, so it goes over on downs to NC State. Tom O'Brien can finally smile because the ball is coming over to his side with less than a minute to go and no timeouts left for the other guys. And this is a good win for them, a really good win.
Credit him and his staff. And banged up, suspensions on the road. Excellent win.
First time that NC State has won here in Charlottesville since 1994, way before Coach O'Brien was in charge. And NC State, last time these two teams played actually at all was 2007 back in Raleigh, and NC State won that game. Tom O'Brien, the last time that NC State won here, Tom O'Brien actually was the offensive coordinator for Virginia. So he lost that game to NC State. This time he wins on the NC State sideline. So the Wolfpack take it 28-14, their first ACC win of the year. They go to 4-3 overall. Virginia falls to 4-3 and 1-2 in the Atlantic Coast Conference. We will see Virginia Thursday night on ESPN. NC State goes to Florida State next week. So our final score, as Mike Glennon throws 3 touchdown passes. NC State beats Virginia 28-14. Coming up next, SportsCenter U. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For Dan Hawkins and our entire production crew, I'm Pam Ward. We say so long from Charlottesville, where the Pack come up with a big win, taking out the Cavaliers 28-14.